For generations, Ebony and Jet magazines were synonymous with black culture and the black experience.
The two publications were founded right here in Chicago, with their founder making history while amassing an enormous empire. That empire is no more. This Black History Month, WGN's Courtney Gooseman dug into what exactly happened.
Johnson Publishing Company has been around for nearly 8 decades, garnering well over $400 million in sales. But the company is now working to crawl out of bankruptcy, auctioning off most of its most precious assets. I sat down with the company's chair and CEO to find out what happened, what's left, and what's next. If these walls could talk, the stories would be endless.
When Chris Brown was just coming out as an artist, his first stop, his publicist had him come to visit Johnson Publishing. And everyone was so excited to see him. I remember he danced all over the carpet. He told us how much he loved Michael Jackson. So he was moonwalking over the carpet.
This is where the who's who of black entertainment, politics, and culture came to be seen and heard. So many historic, memorable moments created in this building at 820 South Michigan.
We posed for that cover story at 2 o'clock in the morning because that's what Kanye wanted. And so this, unfortunately, was the last Mother's Day they had together, and it was for our Mother's Day issue.
Dr. Margina Christian worked for Johnson Publishing Company for nearly 19 years, moving up to senior editor. She also wrote this book about the man behind the historic empire. The company, home to both Ebony and Jet magazine publications, which were centered around the black experience.
Ebony was a lifestyle and more features, mm-hmm. long form stories, general interest. And Jet was everything that happened to African Americans within a week was in Jet. I mean, you knew who got married, you knew who got divorced, you knew who died.
Linda Johnson Rice is the company's chairman and CEO. She's also heir to the publishing empire, which now spans 78 years. It had a workforce that mostly consisted of black women.
Ebony and Jet was finding stories that others had no interest in. We showed the humanity of African Americans, and we were doing more than just trying to enlighten people. We were working to uplift and empower them.
John and Eunice Johnson were the entrepreneurs and the brains behind the company, which launched in 1942. As a child, John came to Chicago from Arkansas with his mother, a part of the Great Migration. He graduated from DuSable High School and went on to study at the University of Chicago. He and Eunice would later publish their first magazine, Negro Digest.
What they saw was a void. Most of the things that you saw about African Americans were not positive. And that's what they wanted to change.
By 1945, Ebony Magazine was born.
They actually didn't anticipate the runaway success of the first issue.
Word spread throughout the African American community and demand for the magazine skyrocketed. 6 years later, Jet rolled out. Johnson used his money and platform to help further the civil rights movement, most notably publishing pictures of the open casket of Emmett Till, the Chicago teen who was lynched in Mississippi in 1955.
Oftentimes in meetings, he would oftentimes talk about that decision and what made him decide to do it, and the reaction of people who felt very uncomfortable, but they kept buying the magazine. And it sold out.
Johnson needed more space, so he teamed up with black Chicago architect John Matusame and built this 110,000 square foot office space across from Grant Park. The 11-story building cost $8 million. It became the first and to this day only skyscraper in downtown Chicago to be built by a black man. By 1971, Johnson Publishing moved in.
And they did everything with rich materials, beautiful detailing, playing with light, that you're just kind of walking around and going, wow.
Wood panels from Mozambique, custom furniture and carpeting, and a massive collection of African art and sculptures, all showcased for readers in the September 1972 issue of Ebony. The empire continued to grow with subscriptions totaling nearly 2 million households during its peak in the 90s. By 2002, Linda Johnson Rice was named chairman and CEO.
If you know any of the traits of an entrepreneur, and they start a business. It's their baby. John Johnson was going to run Johnson Publishing Company till the last breath. And he did.
John Johnson died in 2005, and employees say things changed.
When you wipe everything out, there's like this identity crisis that I would say the magazines went through and the company went through as well.
Then the recession hit in 2008.
The media business became a drain. I really had to decide, is it a building or is it the business?
The building was sold in 2010, and by 2016, Linda sold her father's landmark magazines to a Texas-based company. In April of 2019, Johnson Publishing filed for Chapter 7 bankruptcy with an estimated debt of over $36.5 million.
I did try to really keep everything together. I think I was too emotionally attached to it to move as fast as I might have needed to.
The company's legendary photo archives, art and clothing collections, and cosmetics line all sold at auction, garnering well over $35 million.
People are angry to see what has happened to his legacy. It's a hard pill to swallow.
Right now, neither Ebony nor Jet are in print, only online. Its new owners plagued by subscription issues and lawsuits from unpaid writers. But this landmark building still stands here in Chicago. Rosemont Real Estate Company 3L purchased it in 2017. It's now home to 150 apartments.
All right, look at this view. Lake Michigan and the museum campus.
Can't beat it.
And then look, the iconic Ebony and Jet signs.
Yes, exactly the way it was.
The building was granted landmark status by the city right before it was purchased. Inside, the new owners worked to preserve remnants of the building's history while renting to a whole new generation of students and locals.
The leopard skin pattern, but cheetah pattern or animal pattern.
I see, because the company is still up there.
It was our obligation, even if it wasn't a requirement, to make sure that the history of this building and the story that was attached to it, you know, was here for a long time.
As for the future of Johnson Publishing, Linda tells me the whole story has yet to be written.
We are in the final stages of finishing up the bankruptcy proceedings.
Have we not seen the last of Johnson Publishing?
No, of course not.
Really?
Yeah, but that's all I can tell you.
I reached out to Ebony Media Operations, the Texas company that currently owns Ebony and Jet, to find out about the future of the magazines, but I'm still waiting for a response. Courtney Guzman, WGN News.